Hi, and welcome to the MVAC lab. Today, we're going to take a brief look at MVAC's reference collections. Even with background research, we never know exactly what we'll find when we begin exploring an archaeological site. But we do know that reference collections, sets of positively identified specimens and examples, will help us to identify and sort artifacts from our excavations. MVAC houses reference collections for a range of materials we might find in the La Crosse and Wire region at sites ranging in age from Paleo-Indian to historic. For instance, MVAC has an extensive faunal or animal reference collection, with remains from modern animals identified to species level before they were prepared as references. It includes a range of fish, mammals like this white-tailed deer, reptiles, amphibians, birds, and mussel shells. The collection helps our faunal analysts to identify animal bones, antler, and shell from archaeological sites. Sometimes, analysts can even estimate an animal's size and the amount of meat it would have provided. This offers insights into which animals people pursue for food or other purposes and their habitats, as well as the season or seasons a site was occupied based on species availability or their stages of growth. For identifying floral or plant material, we keep a collection of over 100 species of seeds, nuts, and other plant remains. As with the modern bone collection, the assemblage contains securely identified samples from modern plants. Vials of corn kernels and cob, chenopodium seeds, walnut shell, and more aid in classifying charred archaeological plant remains. This allows us to study plant use, such as when certain cultigens appear in our region, or which nuts people collected and processed at a particular site, and the past environment. We also have lithic raw material samples from Wisconsin and places farther afield, such as Texas, Tennessee, and Ontario, Canada. These samples help us to identify the types of stone native peoples used for making lithic artifacts and where those materials came from. This information aids in studying how people obtained the stone, for instance, with trips to a quarry or through trade, and helps in explaining why particular types of stone, with different traits and availability, were used for certain tools or purposes. Our samples of historic ceramics provide comparisons for sherds from historic archaeological sites. These pieces of stoneware and whiteware are just a few examples. Identifying different ware types and maker's marks helps with dating a site, understanding the activities that took place there, and exploring the cultural practices of the time. Reference collections, along with sources in our library, help us to make accurate identifications and interpret artifacts and plant and animal remains. The better we know what we have, the deeper we can delve into questions of how and why people lived as they did in the past. For further information, links to MVAC's Facebook page, YouTube channel, and Tumblr site, and to view and subscribe to MVAC's e-news, please visit our website at uwlax.edu/MVAC. Thanks for watching.